You can kind of do that in post-production as well, but it's difficult.
Broadcast News 1 is challenging because there's a lot of technical terms and equipment that we have to learn.
All the stuff we've looked at.
UNM journalism professor Richard Schaefer gets to teach his technology-heavy classes in KNME's state-of-the-art broadcast facility.
I don't think you can teach students how to do news production or any type of video production strictly in a classroom. You have to get them out touching the equipment, using it, seeing things with their own eyes, hearing things with their own ears.
It's not all the equipment that's here at this studio. It's literally how to make a film into a narrative.
Schaefer says the concepts behind good narrative television are not necessarily intuitive.
Because watching TV and doing TV are totally different things. And it takes a lot of conscious effort to do television. It doesn't take so much to watch it.
So students have to learn what classic Hollywood filmmakers had discovered generations earlier. That a scene is more interesting if you combine wide shots that establish the scene with medium shots and lots of close-ups, all to form a continuity sequence. Yet those close-ups can't be too similar or they'll violate the 30-degree rule.
You have to move the camera 30 degrees if you're cutting between shots that are the same relative composition. So a close-up and a close-up of the same person will not work.
Other rules, like the 180-degree rule, are so unfamiliar, they have students like Sophia DeConti baffled.
I have no idea what the 180-degree rule is.
Subjects have to keep their relative screen direction so that somebody who's looking left in one shot has to continue to look left in the next shot.
So watching video stories can be a lot easier than making video. Unless, of course, the people who made the video were ignorant of the basic rules of continuity. This is Natalie Penny reporting.